Sources say their father instigated the laughter. Let's go inside for a comment. Apparently, they have no comment. Dads, let this be a reminder that it only takes a moment to make a moment. Call 877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
Welcome back to Our Voices on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. My name is Natasha Nurse, and my guest today is Dr. Nadia Rodriguez. So, doctor, how does social media help or hurt you getting out the message out to the world about proper dental care?
Oh, boy. Well, that's a little bit of a tough question. In some ways, social media is wonderful because it gets people aware of their teeth, of dentistry. But sometimes there can be a lot of false information out there. I remember a few months ago there was an article. Someone said that flossing doesn't prevent cavities, and if you don't floss at all, then nothing's going to happen. That's totally not true. You need to floss your teeth. I can sort of understand maybe where that article was coming from, maybe, but, if you have food in between your teeth, if you don't get it out with floss, the bacteria is going to eat that food. It's going to create an acid. That acid's going to eat away at your teeth. Mm-hmm. You will develop cavities. Not to mention also if you have food or plaque in between your teeth, you'll also develop periodontal disease. So I don't really know where that article came from, but it created quite a stir among the dental community when that came out on social media.
Interesting. Okay. And are there like certain dental trends or things that we as people should be aware of that's going on?
So I would always be very wary of any dental trends. I think most recently I've seen there's some kind of charcoal teeth whitening that everyone on, I think, Instagram is doing, or I don't know. It's basically from my understanding, what it does remove stains, mm-hmm. but you have to be really careful because depending on the size of the grit of the charcoal, mm-hmm. it could actually be removing your enamel. So you have to be very careful. There isn't really a lot of research out there to support doing this charcoal teeth whitening. Really, all it's doing is just removing stains. Mm-hmm. So I would just be very cautious because it could potentially be hurting your teeth rather than making them better. So you just have to be careful.
And do you find in your work that there are certain communities that are like more resistant to proper dental care? And if so, what do you think are contributing factors?
I don't think there's, fear is the contributing factor. I don't think there's any one specific community that avoids to see the dentist. Mm-hmm. But definitely just misinformation and fear. Those are the things that really keep people away.
Absolutely. Okay. And what was I going to say? What would you say has been the most meaningful lesson you've learned, I guess, in your practice as a dentist and just like servicing and working with people?
One of the most important lessons I think I've learned in dentistry is not to assume that patients are not trying to keep their teeth healthy. Sometimes when you see a patient that has what we call like a bombed out mouth, cavities everywhere, it's not because they're sitting at home eating bonbons or, sometimes it's because this person has two kids and doesn't have time to brush her teeth properly. Mm-hmm. If it's a child that has cavities, sometimes it's a mom that's working two or three jobs just trying to make ends meet. Mm-hmm. And that's why she can't watch her children brush their teeth properly. You should never judge anybody. Everybody many people are subjected to different stresses, and those are just a lot of different reasons why people develop a poor mouth, poor dental hygiene, and you should just never you should never accuse anybody of anything without really knowing the whole story.
I love that you said that, because actually I would say, you know, it's interesting. You know, every industry is different, but I would say there's definitely like a shame factor that most people experience while going to the dentist, right? So, for me, just recently, I went in and, you know, there's two things that always happen. First, it's like, oh, well, are you flossing enough? You know, you better be flossing enough. And then they'll just say, oh, well, you know, your name is Nurse, Natasha, so you must be a nurse, which is completely false. I hope everyone understands Alex Baker is not a baker. Natasha Nurse. Nurse is just a last name. Get it together, people.
Yeah.
But
yeah, well, a lot of patients also, I think, do feel ashamed or silly when I ask them, you know, do you know how to floss? And the truth is, a lot of people really don't know how to floss.
Yes.
Like, they think that they do.
Yes.
But they actually are doing it completely wrong. And they feel silly when I hold the mirror up in front of them and I give them a piece of floss and I'm like, show me how it is that you floss your teeth. And instead of flossing properly, they're just cutting their gums up, or they're just moving food from one area of their mouth to another area. So it's just, but they're in dentistry, like, really nobody should have any shame. Nobody's perfect, or I should say very few people are perfect. And the whole point of dentistry, the whole point of dentistry is just to teach people how to better take care of their mouths, to solve any problems that they do have. That's really the point. There's really no shame. As long as if you're at the dental office, you're already in the right direction. You're taking the right steps.
I love it. I love it. You are listening to Our Voices on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. My name is Natasha Nurse, and my special guest today is Dr. Nadia Rodriguez. So Nadia, Dr. Rodriguez, rather, I really appreciate that you say that, because, you know, for people, you know, who, yeah, maybe could floss a bit more, you know, there is no shame. And, you know, with that, I hope everyone else listening as well can, you know, definitely feel like, you know, we're in this struggle together and the struggle is real, but there is a bright, you know, we can get better. So before I get onto the rapid fire questions, just for everyone listening, I love your approach to dentistry and how you're talking about it. So if other people are interested in learning more about your practice, what's the best way that they can reach out to you?
Yeah, they could go to our website. It's www.nolimitsdental.com, or they could even call the office at 212-757-5565.
Okay, I love it. Okay, so now let's do some rapid-fire questions. And so I call them rapid-fire questions because you have to answer very quickly or we'll be on fire. No, I'm just joking. but listen, time is money, right? So with that, what is the number one thing on your bucket list?
I really want to go to Dubai.
Ooh, beautiful. Why?
I probably never will, but...
Oh, I don't want to say that. Yeah, why Dubai?
I don't know. It just looks like a magical place.
Where you can meet Aladdin and Jasmine, yes.
Yeah, I have no reason to go there. Like, there's nothing that would ever pull me in that direction, which is why I feel like I'll probably never go. But it just looks like a beautiful place. I would love to go see it.
I agree. Very, very cool. Okay, what is your favorite place in the world as of right now?
Punta Cana in the Dominican Republic.
Muy bueno. Nice. Okay, okay. Favorite song?
Oh, my God, favorite song. Well, I guess I'm just going to stick to something that's just playing a lot on the radio right now. So I really like that Camila song, Havana. It always gets me going.
Very nice. Okay. If you were not being a dentist, you would be fill in the blank.
A dog walker.
Oh, Butch Butch. Yes. I love it.
Yeah.
The animals.
They would be really, really happy every day just seeing lots of puppies.
Do you have any or no?
Yeah, I have a Weimaraner.
Oh, beautiful.
But for my daughter, she's the second best reason to come home.
Oh, beautiful. I love it. Okay. Who motivates you? Who's like someone who just like gets you going and you're like, I can do anything?
Honestly, you're going to laugh probably, but it's people like you.
Aww. You get that a lot? You're so sweet. Thank you. Oh, gosh.
You do a lot. So when I see people like yourself, I'm just like, how do they have time to do anything? It pushes me to do even more.
You're so sweet. But see, I told you I'm not flossing enough. That's why. But thank you. You're so sweet. I love that. How do you relax and unwind?
Oh, I'm a big nature person, so if I could spend any time going to the park or go to the beach, just get my feet in like the sand or the dirt or the grass, that automatically relaxes me.
I love it. Okay. What are you currently watching on TV right now?
So I'm not a big TV show, like I'm not religious about any specific TV shows. I will say that I get really excited when I watch Blackish on TV.
Yeah.
I like that show a lot. Or anything like Modern Family.
Yeah.
Any of those comedies, I enjoy them.
Okay, I love it. Absolutely. And if you could go back and give yourself advice in the past, what would you say to yourself and how old would you be when you went back?
I would go back to my college age years and I would tell myself that everything is going to be okay and it's okay, you can go to that party.
Oh. Yes, I remember you and I were both very much head in the book. So that's actually perfect advice. That makes total sense. Oh, my gosh. You're too funny. And how would you describe yourself in 5 words or less?
Successful, detail-oriented dental mom.
Oh, yes. And how old is your baby? And tell me one quick thing about the baby.
She's 7 months old, and she is a handful.
Sweetness. And her name?
Anya.
Beautiful, beautiful. Absolutely. So, Dr. Nadia Rodriguez, thank you so much for coming onto the show. It's been great catching up, and thank you for just sharing the realities of dental care and why it matters.
Thank you for so much for having me. Thank you.
Absolutely. And I hope our audience found you both as informative and inspiring as I did. My name is Natasha Nurse. I'm the proud host of Our Voices here on 90.3 WHPC. Our show's creative director is Rudy J. Breedy. Visit nccradio.org. Again, that is www.nccradio.org for more information. This will be available as a podcast on iTunes, Android Podcasts, and Spreaker. Our Voices is powered by the Nassau Community College Foundation on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. Have a great day, and we'll see you soon.